WGN Investigates goes one-on-one with the Chicago FBI boss. He arrives in the midst of one of the most wide-ranging political corruption probes in decades. But the new FBI leader is no stranger to our city.
And I believe to this day that in some regards I probably had a guardian angel, because I never got to the point where I was hurt or injured or anything like that, but I came close.
Emerson Bowie grew up in Chicago's Inglewood neighborhood and still remembers navigating gang turf and violence during those years. While at Lindblom High School, he credits a math teacher and football with giving him a perspective beyond his neighborhood.
Growing up in a predominantly black environment, the more you're exposed to other people, it changes you and it prepares you for what you're going to face when you go out into the real world.
For Bowie, the real world included a part-time job managing a Taco Bell downtown.
When I became a manager, you know, I was real big into making sure that you lead from the front, you lead by example.
Before joining the Army, earning a Bronze Star, and then signing up with the FBI.
I am a patriot, you know, I mean, being a combat veteran.
Perhaps that helps explain the Captain America collection in his office. Bowie comes to Chicago from El Paso, his transfer delayed by a mass shooting at a local Walmart.
All I want to do is find my mom. Somebody needs to tell me where she is. I want to know if she's dead or alive or if she's still in Walmart.
22 people were killed by a gunman accused of specifically targeting Hispanics.
It's not a matter of if, in most cases, it's a matter of when. So everyone has the responsibility to prepare.
28 days after the El Paso Walmart shooting, Bowie's FBI field office also responded to Midland and Odessa, Texas, where a gunman with a history of mental health problems killed 7 people.
Oh my God.
In a lot of instances, there were signs before the actual incident occurred. So what we have to do a better job of doing to prevent some of these things is educating the public and encouraging the public and gaining the public's trust to know that it's the right thing to do to come forward and notify law enforcement so we can try and prevent it.
At the FBI in Chicago, Bowie inherits a wide-ranging, still unfolding investigation into political corruption. Nearly a dozen Democrats from the city to the suburbs have either pled guilty, been charged, or are named in federal search warrants. Bowie won't talk about specific cases, but said many times the motivations are similar.
They probably do it for personal reasons. They may do it for ego. They may do it for stature. They may do it just because, in some instances, power has the ability to corrupt, unfortunately. And when those instances happen, we're going to pursue it.
After 28 years with the Bureau,
from where I came from and where I grew up, yeah, that amazed me.
A career that's taken him from Colorado to London and investigations involving everything from corruption to cybersecurity, Bowie says he's happy to be back in his hometown, where the gang violence that intruded on his youth continues to be a concern.
It would be nice to be able to say we can arrest our way out of a problem, but I think the problem pretty much goes deeper than that. You know, there's social issues that are involved in that, and there are opportunity issues that are involved that have to be integrated in the plan to try and squelch a lot of the violence.
Emerson Bowie also has the distinction of being the first African-American to lead the FBI's Chicago office. He said he hopes to be an example, showing kids from his old neighborhood in Inglewood and beyond that there are bright futures ahead if you work hard.